let me make it part of this. No worries. Okay, OBJ refresh and lock, right? See, OBJ refresh and lock method you will be using in case whenever you wanted to go ahead and do open a record from the table. For same purpose, you have OBJ open also, correct? Then why do you need to go ahead with OBJ refresh and lock? So there is a specific meaning that you are going to use. Okay, let me add one more method. Just hang on, please. That is OBJ open, I'm telling you, right? OBJ open. If you closely observe between OBJ open and OBJ refresh and lock, what is missing? You can tell me. One second. What is missing? Mainly what is missing? Okay, the class here you mentioned and the class page, related page you will mention here. So class will be read from page here, but you are independently passing the class here. That's not a big deal, but something else is missing. In the lock, OBJ open and OBJ refresh and lock, something is missing. What is that?
Lock checkbox is missing.
Means you are acquiring lock. See, you have a choice of whether to acquire lock or not. See, you do OBJ open in case when you want to fetch single record based on class key and you use it as read only. Or in other case, you use OBJ open to open a record and update the record back. If you want to update the record, what you have to do? You have to mandatorily lock it before you update it. But here you are using it simply for read only purpose, you are not locking it. So lock is optional when you are using OBJ open, depends on your business requirement. But you are using OBJ refresh and lock, it will do OBJ open and acquire lock. That is first thing. But again, it will not acquire lock always. Let me tell you another situation. That is, when you are using OBJ open, suppose you are acquiring lock. By the time your OBJ open gets executed and you are acquiring lock, already someone has acquired lock on this. What will happen to this method is it will throw an error message like lock is being acquired, so step status will fail. So you need to do your own exception handling in case if you're using OBJ open. At the jump, you have to do if step status fails and all, then it has to go ahead and do something. But in case of OBJ refresh and lock, if lock is acquired already on the respective class and the respective record where the temp page has some key value, temp page has some key property value for that record, already lock is acquired, this method will not have any impact. It will not fail. That is exception handling. It will not fail at all. Suppose lock is not there, then it will open the record and freshly reload this page with the latest data, acquire lock and proceed forward. So exception handling mechanism of OBJ open in case of locking is being provided with a method called OBJ refresh and lock. Okay, in case if you are using OBJ refresh and lock, you use it in such a situation where you feel like a record may be acquired with lock. In the situation, record is already acquired, I don't want to refresh the data, proceed forward without failure. And if record is not acquired with lock, it has to reload the page and then use the latest data. In such a situation, you will go for this. Otherwise, you go for OBJ open. Make sense?
Yes.
Okay. So this is